Welcome to All Pro Football Data. My name is Jim Coburn. In today's episode, we're talking about Edrin Cooper, Texas A&M linebacker, in terms of his production data profile and other statistical factors. He was named All-SEC in 2023, and many consider him to be a day one linebacker. But what does his data say? These are things that we're going to be looking at today. So, if you're new to the channel, new to the stuff that I do, the biggest thing I look at is defensive market share data. So you can pause the video real quick to kind of get a look at that. But what this data looks at is solo tackles, sacks, and tackles for loss, and the percentage of that he made of his team compared to positional peers. Based on his data, he had a 67 score in terms of solo tackles, 87 in terms of sacks, and then 90 percentile in terms of tackle for loss. He was very impactful as a pass rusher. When I did his data initially and just looked at him, just looking at his raw numbers, I thought, okay, well, this is a pass rusher. But a lot of people view him as a pursuit linebacker. So it was kind of a little odd from that kind of perspective. This, of course, is out of 2,999 linebackers since the 1989 NFL draft class. Moving to his other market share scores, looking at interceptions, forced fumbles, pass deflections, he scored really well in terms of those scores as well, well into the 90 percentile in terms of his interception market share. His pass deflection market share was in the 80 percentile, and then he was in the 70 percentile in terms of forced fumble market share. So he's pretty much a linebacker that can do everything, but his solo tackle data is a little bit lower. Moving on to adjusted production scores. Adjusted production takes a look at the age of a prospect. What team did he play on? Was it a strong team, you know, like Alabama or Michigan, you know, a team that's going to go to the national championship? Or is it a team like in the MAC, like an Old Dominion or something like that? It also looks at strength of schedule, you know, what type of schedule did he face, you know, the teams that he faced, to kind of give context to the production. So taking a look at his context production, he had a good age score of 83.46 out of 100. His MSA rating was 87.46. And his pass rating was 94.90 out of 100. Those numbers are good, but not great. I think the biggest thing that kind of lowers him is this solo tackle market share. That's the biggest thing pulling his profile down. When you go to comparisons for him, this is why solo tackle data matters so much. Because when you look at the comparisons for him based on his pass score, his MSA rating, his age, and those sort of factors, Edrin Cooper tests are kind of like Geno Hayes, DeAndre Levi, linebackers that are not elite. So they're linebackers that are very good, but not really elite, because most elite linebackers had elite solo tackle market share. There's the occasional guy here and there. You know, obviously Fred Warner would kind of be a big example of that, who had elite pass deflection interception data, which Cooper does have pretty close to that. And then, of course, you have linebackers like Derek Brooks, who's very similar as well, but he had lower solo tackle data. But he really was more of a safety at Florida State in a lot of ways. But anyways, Edrin Cooper, based on his solo tackle data, the comparisons for him, when you look at the data from a data perspective, are a little all over the place, I would say. Now, in terms of outlook, Edrin Cooper profiles as a backup to fringe Pro Bowler long term. Patrick Queen would probably be the closest linebacker to this profile. So a linebacker that had lower solo tackle data that went in the first round. I know a lot of people are putting him day one. He might test amazing as an athlete, went to the Senior Bowl, did really well. So he probably is going to be a first-round linebacker. So the closest kind of comp for him would be like a Patrick Queen. But there are some issues with this solo tackle data. In terms of, I have a hard time projecting him as like a surefire Pro Bowl, all-pro player, because of that lack of solo tackle production. Because most elite pursuit linebackers, guys like Luke Kuechly, Ray Lewis, Brian Urlacher. I mean, you could list a whole bunch of different types of linebackers that had elite solo tackle production, and he doesn't really have that. So you're kind of looking at him more as like a finesse linebacker. So he could be like an elite finesse linebacker, I guess is the best way to put it. Not to take anything away from him, but that's just how he looks on his production side. But with all that stuff out of the way, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Jim Coburn, also known as Jimmetrics on Twitter. You can check me out on there, or also known as X now. And you can also check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/jcoburn. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace, everybody. Peace.